as an empty your mind. Be formless, shapeless, like water. Now you put water into a cup, it becomes the cup. You put water into a bottle, it becomes the bottle. You put it in a teapot, it becomes the teapot. Now water can flow or it can crash. Be water, my friend.
In the name of humanity, or in the name of love, or in the name of God. Hi everyone. You know me. Maybe further of you, you know me as a person that names Vito Tramiel, as a JKD researcher of Master Bruce Lee. And on the other hand, JKD is not for the person of Bruce. JKD is like energy, has a philosophy meaning. And in this session, we continue the reality of Bruce Lee or Li Xiaolang or Li Zhongfan as a Chinese name. And before this session, at the first session, we talked for example, Bruce Lee was born in 27 of November in 1940 as his birthday, and so in front. In Francisco, at U.S. country, at Chinese hospital in Chinatown, and other something like this, and he's grow up. He's gonna grow up until 6 years old. After that, he came to the Hong Kong. Yes. Hong Kong, and in between his 6 year old boy was a 6 year old boy, and until 18 year old boy, the challenge he was a special challenges with for example as a he. He got a medal for dancing. He got champion dancing. He was a good dancer, professional dancer as a cha-cha, and he got a champion boxing of between high schools in China, and. On the other hand, he found that Master Ip Chun as a Wing Chun as a Fosho. And further of you maybe know Wushu. Kung Fu in China Kung Fu has a special meaning. as a public meaning. Kung Fu, for example, China people, for example, said Kung Fu, said to the Kung Fu world, for example, if you hard, if you, for example, if you do hard everything, you got the Kung Fu. You do Kung Fu. Kung Fu. It means trying hard. Doing trying hard for everything. That is Kung Fu. The Kung Fu means this, not martial arts. And Wushu has a special meaning for, I didn't know Kung Fu, what is the meaning of Kung Fu, what is the meaning of Wushu. Wushu in Chinese, traditional or Chinese Mandarin, or Chinese, as a public Chinese, has a meaning Wushu. Wu is meaning, Wushu is meaning the warrior, art of warrior, or art of fighting, Wushu. Yes, Wushu. And at that time in China, in for example, long time ago, it goes back to the, for example, the year of 1902, we had two Wushu, two kinds of Wushu in China. When it's already about as a historical of China or historical of World War I. It goes back to the World War One, where the U.S. or U.S. country and Germany and Japan country attacked the China country, and at that time China there is no enough instruments as a guns, for example, like this for fighting to the enemy. China's for example, and at that time it's the biggest revolution of China's boxer, and one of them is it was Master Yi. Yes, one of these boxer, Chinese boxer in China, and that fighting with the enemy like U.S. country or U.S. American or Japanese or English, as in England, yes, and we fight with hand, with Wushu. This is Wushu.
The beginning of the 20th century found the 2,000-year-old Chinese empire in decline. Foreign powers descended like vultures on what was left of the dying Manchu dynasty. The once powerful Chinese people fumed as they saw their land and protectorates taken over by foreigners. Hong Kong and Burma were lost to England, Korea to Japan, and Vietnam to France. As the power structure within the Manchu court struggled to maintain its tenuous control within China, foreign encroachment intensified internal political conflicts. What had been an ancient closed society was threatened by the corruption of progress and foreign influence.
When the United States gained control of the Philippines as a result of the Spanish-American War, many saw the possession of the islands as a gateway to large markets in mainland Asia. American products could be sold there, and many capitalists envisioned a new and untapped market for investors in large-scale railroad construction. At the dawn of the 20th century, American factories were producing more goods than the country could consume, and the continued growth of the American economy depended on exports to foreign markets. China had been weakened by war and enormous amounts of foreign intervention. Britain, France, Germany, Russia, and Japan all had established settlements along China's coast. These nations also managed sizable spheres of influence where each country maintained strict economic control. The U.S. government and American investors began to fear a future in which China would be carved into European colonies that were closed to American products and companies. With American interest in mind, the U.S. Secretary of State, John Hay, issued a series of policy statements that became known as the Open Door Notes. These were letters addressed to the leaders of European powers, suggesting that nations share trading rights in China.
By lake.
Hostilities that had been simmering for decades exploded when China declared war against the foreign powers of France, Russia, England, Japan, Austria, Italy, Germany, and the United States. The Chinese became distrustful of foreigners and were greatly concerned by the influx of Christian missionaries who converted an increasing number of Chinese to an alien religion. A campaign of terror had begun the previous year when a secret organization called the Boxers began killing Christian missionaries and their converts in the northern provinces of China. The Boxers were a clandestine social society that had been in existence since the early 1700s. The group preached a mixture of Buddhist, Confucian, and Taoist ideas and was rabidly opposed to any change in ancient culture. Members practiced a form of shadow boxing and believed that followers of the cult were invulnerable.
1,000 villages deep in China mirrored her primitive hatred of the foreign devil. Moreover, their passions had found flag and leaders as a secret brotherhood, the Boxers, began to flourish. Kill the white man, burn his mission, said the Boxers, claiming magic charms could make their bodies impervious to Western bullets. With the Empress' consent, in early 1900, they began to kill.
Our story begins with the death of He Yun Jia. He was poisoned. By whom? For what?
China country has especially fighting with north of China and south of China. Okay? Do you know what I mean? And this is a inside warrior, inside fighting, inside I don't know what to say. Yes. At that time has a two kind of worship, and north of China has a special worship with line worship. In the movement, for example, in the fighting, has a two kind of techniques. Yes, techniques is North Bushu technique or South Bushu. The North Bushu, the movement is a footage, for example, is a line movement. Yes. Fighting with the distance, over and from far away distance. Yes, like this and line with the line or feet or punch with hand into line distance. As a punch, as a kick, and and the south of China, between two people, for example, yes, like this, look, morning, and like this, morning, and at that time, as a especially bushu. And go back to the Bruce Lee, the reality of Bruce Lee. And Bruce Lee studied with as a student of Wing Chun in the school Wing Chun martial art. That is reading in this martial art at Wing Chun, with Master Yi Chun at that time. And until 18 years old. And in 1960, in 1958, he went to the US because pressure of the spiritual, because spiritual is very not good for him, and he went to the another country or where to be free energy. Yes, he wants to free everybody wants has to freedom as a free human, and he went to the US and at that time, and the first of the thing that Bruce Lee, this is a basic minimum of living off as a human or as a person in the US country. And he worked hard for living in US at that time. And this is, I forgot about the Muhammad Ali Khelei. The role of Muhammad Ali Khelei, Master Muhammad Ali Khelei, and God bless him, and legends never die. And for Bruce Lee liked very much, in as a his vision of Muhammad Ali Khelei, because he was a supervision or as a vision of human, and he found that with the for example government of US or other country as a slavery, to the slavery of black black man.
What did you discuss back in the hotel room?
Nothing, just friends, just like cruise ship and Kennedy and everybody. When the people, all of the politicians of all other white races come together, and they, although they believe different, they think different, whites can come together and discuss the common cause. But whenever a few of us come together, the world is shook up. And I say, whatever went back there, it's our business.
Reverend King, do you agree?
Oh, yes, yes. We had a very good discussion on many matters, and of course these are not things that we would discuss here, but we do have common problems and common concerns, and above all, as Muhammad Ali has just said, we are all victims of the same system of oppression, and even though we may have different religious beliefs, this does not at all bring about a difference in terms of our concern.
Still brothers. Do you share the same, one more question, do you share the same concern that Muhammad has for his draft status?
Oh, I certainly do. My views on the draft are very clear. I'm against it. And I think the sooner our country does away with the draft, the better it will be for everybody. I'm very disturbed about the militaristic posture of our nation. And I think until we have a radical reordering of priorities in our country, we are going more and more to the depths and, I should say, to the doom that follows arrogance of power, as Senator Fulbright said.